The piece that you will hear is called The Light of Day, and it is a medley that otherwise have never seen the light of day. So thanks for listening.
So this next piece is an arrangement of a TV show called Brussels. It is a dark political thriller.
This is a piece I actually wrote for the Helix Collective. It's called The Littlest Things. It's maybe a celebration of how some of the smallest things in our lives can make the biggest impact.
It's essentially a concerto for flute and clarinet. But it's not about the gentle soaring that we think about. It's a very athletic thing.
Thank the Composers Diversity Collective.
The CDC is a nonprofit whose mission is to expand the perception of who a composer is and what a composer looks like, both in the concert hall and on the scoring stage.
They wrote us wonderful music.
It was inspired by a story I had found on Twitter about a woman and a young girl who ended up helping each other through the beginning of this pandemic. Their encounter began with a makeshift fairy garden and turned into a relationship of healing.
How do you get rid of a neighbor's rooster crowing? Asking for a friend. Surprised I'm not the only one to acquire. Turns out the crows are the dudes to call to mate. I am awake 24/7 because some cornerous dudes need chicks. Such a desperate cause.
We found ourselves in the midst of a pandemic and protest that Breathe was brought to life. And it came out of a desire to add my voice to so many voices that were protesting the lives that were cut short through gun violence, through police brutality, through just not having opportunity.
The piece you'll be hearing is loosely based on the main theme from a film I scored recently called Mid-Century.
It's a tribute to my mom, but it's also an invitation to feel your grief, but to also send off with love and light and joy those you were unable to say goodbye to. The piece is bookended with a song that my mom taught me and that I'll share with you. So inclined, please join me with Viva. At the end of the piece.
Viva!